Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the Be a Photographer channel. Welcome to episode 2 of the Capture One tutorial series. And in this video, I'm going to walk you through the exposure control basics in Capture One Pro 20. On the left side in the exposure panel, you'll see that we have white balance, exposure, and high dynamic range as our first three options in this tab. If you don't see those options, make sure you're in the exposure tab here, which is at the top and looks like a little histogram mountain range. Let me show you first the automatic adjustments button in Capture One Pro 20, which you'll find in almost any of the adjustments. You'll see here it looks like a little magic wand with a little sparkly dust on top of it, and when you click, it will automatically adjust the exposure for you, and it can also do contrast, brightness, and saturation. For this image, Capture One Pro 20 thought that just adjusting the exposure is good enough. So I kind of like where it is right now. It's a little bit bright for my taste, so I'm going to drag it down. And what's nice is you can just drag slowly to the left or to the right, and that will control the exposure of your image. Think of this as the main exposure slider, and that's what it is. It can either bring your image down in exposure by sliding to the left, or you can reset and slide to the right, and that will bring the exposure up. What's nice is resetting is really easy. You can double tap anywhere on the timeline and it will set to 0, or you can just type 0 on the right side here to reset any of the sliders. So if you do the contrast, you want to reset it, just type 0, or if you do it, you can double tap wherever you want and it will reset. That'll save you a lot of time in the long run. So for this image, I want to go up maybe to 0.4, 0.5. Let's see, right about there, 0.53. Each image will be different, of course, unless you're shooting in a studio like here, then you could copy and paste those adjustments to a bunch of images at a time. But there's the exposure. So again, that does our main exposure, and I wound it up just a tiny, tiny bit. So there we go. And that will do a majority of the work for you in a lot of your images when you're just getting started. Next, we have the contrast slider. Now, contrast is the difference between how bright your bright spots are versus how dark the dark spots are. For instance, if we zoom in here, you can see that we still have some detail in the hair under the chin and below the ear here, and that's because we have contrast set at 0. If we went for a really high contrast, and I wouldn't recommend this, but this is for demonstrations, you can see that the shadows basically became black, so we lost all that detail there, and the bright spots, like the bright highlights on her cheekbone here, just disappeared. We have very high contrast, and you can see again if we reset, we had detail in the skin, we had some detail in the hair, and when we bring that contrast up all the way, we lose it. Sometimes you want a punchy, high contrast fashion look, but I'd recommend keeping it toned down a little bit. So for this image, I'd say right around 14 is pretty good. And you can see if we hold the Alt or Option key and hold this arrow, that was before, this is after. So all we changed so far is the exposure and contrast slider. Then we have our brightness slider, and I usually don't mess with the brightness at all. Think of this kind of as a secondary backup to exposure. It's a little bit hard for me to explain the differences, but you can see if we bring brightness down to 0, it does not do what bringing the exposure down does. So this is just kind of overall image brightness, and I'd say this is more for fine tuning once you have the exposure where you'd like it. And saturation is easily explainable. Right now we have it saturated with colors. If we went to 0, it would make the image black and white. I think this looks pretty good, and a personal kind of flavor tip of mine is to bring saturation down to go black and white and then contrast up. And you can see that when we have black and white with high contrast, it looks pretty good. If we went color, I don't think it looks as neat. So I'm gonna leave this right around 13 as we had it before, and reset the saturation. If we wanted the colors to really pop, and this is going to be a little bit too much, then we can go to the right, and you can see that it adjusts the skin tones and the background and the makeup and everything, and I'll show you in another video how to do a layer mask, so if you just wanted to change the saturation of the background, we can do that without affecting the skin or the outfit at all. Next up, let's move into high dynamic range. High dynamic range is going to be more useful in settings where you're shooting things that are really dark and really bright. For instance, a landscape image, portraits outdoors, maybe something with a darker foreground or background. And to give you an example of that, I'm just going to go to an image I took of my Panasonic GH5 and the monitor on top. You can see if we reset this image, the actual camera itself is pretty dark. The image on the monitor here looks correct, but I want to bring some more detail up in the camera so that you can see the details on these buttons. Now to do that, I could bring the exposure up, but when you see, we do that, and then the highlights get blown out. So we can barely read this license plate I have on the wall here. We can't see anything on this display, and the image looks very messed up on this top monitor. So what I'm going to do instead is just adjust a little bit using my exposure. So that's about where I want it. And then I can use the shadow slider here to bring up just the shadows. So you can see that's bringing those details back in the camera on the body itself, but it's not changing this image here. So again, if we bring the shadows up, you'll see that this does almost no change, just brings the blacks up a little bit. And if we were to do exposure, then it would do the whole image and blow out the image. So again, when you have something with a high dynamic range, that's where you want to use the HDR or high dynamic range panel. And here you can see we can bring the shadows up. Now, what's the difference between shadow and black control? So you can see we can bring the blacks up and we can bring the shadows up, but they do slightly different things. And I'd say, again, this is like brightness versus exposure. It's kind of a fine tuning control that you have in terms of the range. Let's say I want to bring up this portion of the image, like I mentioned before. If I were to just turn up the black points, it would bring up the camera and the darker points. You can see there's kind of black here. There's black on these knobs and dials, and it works pretty well. You can see that now we can see the buttons on the camera. If I reset this, you can see it did a pretty good job and it didn't adjust the screen. Whereas if I were to do shadows, it will also kind of grab the shadows around here, and I'd say not look as good. So you can see shadows brought everything up, whereas blacks only brought up the black points of the camera. And for this image, I would use just the black control and then add a little bit of contrast so it doesn't look as washed out. And to bring this monitor down, I'll just give you a sneak peek of doing a layer mask. So we'll create new layer mask. I'll call this camera monitor. And then if we grab a brush by either tapping here or pressing B on the keyboard, we can just draw a mask here. And if I press the M key on my keyboard, you can see I have that area selected. And with just that mask, I can now either control the exposure there to perfect that, or I could use the high dynamic range and bring the highlights down. And you can see now we have a much better looking image just by using that layer mask. And there's so much you can do with layer masks in Capture One Pro 20. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something of it. If you're more advanced than this, please understand this series is for beginners just getting started with Capture One Pro 20 and photo editing in general. If you moved over from Lightroom, a lot of the things will feel familiar, but I want to make a walkthrough so you can start from the very beginning and get used to photo editing in general and doing that in Capture One Pro 20. If you enjoyed, please leave a comment, subscribe as it really helps out, and leave this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.